Okay. I think I figured this out. Is there a chat? Okay, so everybody's doing all right. And if this is not good for the channel, please just kill it or let me know in the chat. I'm not sure if I can see the chat. I think I can see the chat. But I just figured it'd be cool to paint and chat with you guys for a little while I add some color to the bases on my old Grenadier skellies right here. And I'm just gonna get started. So, get one of my bigger brushes. This is my dry palette, for lack of a better word, because I don't have a wet palette yet. I haven't gotten into that. And I should have shook these paints up before I started. I'll shake them up now, and I'll get some fresh water because this water has some Elmer's glue in it. I'm hoping you guys are having a good Saturday. It's kind of quiet here at the house today, and there's my son on cue. Yes, son. Or what? Why, yes. Why? Huh? I think you're going overkill on what you're doing. Look at this. Oh, wait, here, look. Here. Okay, well, that's all I got. Whoa, thank you. That's great. And that's how you know we're live, guys. So, I'm going to destroy my 40-year-old skellies. For those of you who haven't seen the first two parts of me basing this, these are my old skellies from way back when. I'm not going to repaint him. I'm just basing them. Kind of get a homogeneous look to them so they can match all my other newer minis. I'm going to water this down a little bit. And just start adding color. To the bases that I added texture to earlier today. I would be very interested in hearing about what you guys might have going on your bench today. weekend, I started doing, well, I was going to do this anyways, but like I said before, I was, there's been one or two guys asking how to base the pre-Slotta minis on plastic bases, and I thought I'd do a video about it. So far it's turned into three videos. I did some of it this morning on Twitch, but I might be moving away from Twitch. I see there's some powder on his foot that I don't want. So I'm going to try to move that out. I want these guys to be on some kind of arid terrain. So I'm going to try to replicate a basing job I did on a previous mini a few months ago. So I haven't really had a chance to do a lot. Hey, somebody's how you doing? Thanks for watching. Hope you're doing all right. I'm trying to figure out how this Go Live stuff works on Facebook, but not sure I got it 100% yet. Do me a favor if you can type something in the chat, because I'm not even sure I could see the chat. But we're just adding some basing to my old Grenadier skellies from when I was a kid today. Since we're all locked in with nowhere to go, as I am sure many of you are as well. Kind of want all their bases to match, so they're all going to get the same treatment. Hey guys, happy Saturday, hope everyone's doing alright. I'm just globbing some color on these bases, gotta be careful not to get it on the mini, cause I'm not repainting these. These are 40 year old paint jobs that I'm just gonna keep. But I wanted to put them on some 25 millimeter bases so that the next time they come out in a dungeon, they'd be a little more homogeneous with the rest of my guys. trying to see if, let's see. If I can see your comments. Oh yeah, I can see comments. Okay. Nice. Yeah, I can see comments, so feel free to comment. By all means. Let me know what you're up to. Let me know if you have any questions about what I'm doing, or if you want to talk about anything else, I'm happy to oblige. But I just kind of wanted to hang out with somebody today while I did this. And since nobody can really come over, or we can't really go out, then I've just come to realize that my friends at Old School Miniatures are probably the best crowd to hang out with while I do this. So I got 7 of these guys that I'm working on at the same time. Earlier this morning, I had added this texture and baking soda and sand to the bases. And now I'm just sealing them in with some paint, as well as getting some color on them. I am by no means a professional. But I do enjoy this, and it's a nice way to wind down. At the end of the day, or a rough week. Especially, I guess I've had a rough week, considering some of the things that are going on. I'm not too worried about getting paint on the edges of the base, because I'll always go back when I'm done and edge it in black. I just like edging them in black. That's just a bunch of goop what I've done there. It's not, can't be good. We'll see what we can save. Yeah. You guys are probably bored. You guys probably rather do this on your own, because you do this all the time than watch somebody else do it, I'm sure. That's fine too. I know I've watched Dave paint, and a friend of mine, I'm nearsighted, so I get close up to the mini when I'm adding color to it. I'm always baffled how they hold the mini so far away from themselves to paint, and it looks awesome. Those guys did great work. You know who we should get to do a live video is Pennyfew. Pennyfew Painting does great work. I'd love to see him live in action. I got a bunch of paint on the back of this end of the brush, which is not good for the brush, but I'm not too worried about it. I just want to get this material to soak up the pigment and color. When it dries, it'll kind of hold it together. And I plan on sealing it, so that should be good. I see something I want to remove. I could use this guy right here to get it. It'll work. When I painted these back in the 80s, oof, I used testers and Tamiya oil-based paints. They've held up pretty good over the years. I mean, technically they would require a new paint job, but like I said earlier, I'm gonna kinda wanna preserve them as is, just for me. Right now I'm just knocking off some of the powder that I actually got on the mini. Let's see. Trying to figure out how I do some of this stuff on live stream here. I was hesitated calling this guy a lich, but he's obviously some kind of lich, but, well, maybe not. So, in a module, a pretty famous module, that shall remain unnamed here, the lich isn't really a body, it's just a skull. So, this is technically, maybe it's a pre-lich wizard, huh? Interesting, no? Oh, hi guys. See, there's four of you guys watching. Thanks for coming by. I appreciate it. Hope you're having a good Saturday. I think it's Saturday. Yeah, I was off yesterday. That's why I'm confused. But that was for Good Friday. Technically, I'm off for a while because they've shut the doors for the moment where I'm at. So, but unfortunate, well, not unfortunate. I won't have as much time as you would think to hobby, even though there's no work. We got projects that we'll come back online as soon as this stuff is over, so I'll probably be working to get those going. Let this dry and do a second pass at it later. But I got time today, so I've been hobbying most of the day today. Hey, hi David. Hope you're doing alright. Hope you don't mind. I just, Mick said he wanted to see more live stream, and these are old school, so I figured I'd live stream with my friends here. You know, besides watching your daily life posts are kind of inspiring if you didn't know. I appreciate them. I don't always get to watch them because I had been working. I believe you're 6 hours ahead of me. So when you're live streaming, I'm typically already at the office. So I get the alert, but I don't get to watch. If you didn't know what I was doing, these are my old Grenadier guys. I think I posted them before. And these are the old paint jobs I did when I was a kid. And I don't plan on repainting them, but I did want to give them proper bases. So that's kind of what I'm doing. So I don't want to get any paint on the old school paint job they've got. I'm trying to remember what the box that these guys came in looked like. They came with a mounted knight, undead knight, with a spear. So I guess I'm not sure if he's a knight if he's got a spear, but. And a king that was held up over the shoulders of two other skeletal warriors. I've got those guys in a box, and they'll be, that's another project because my mounted warrior is all messed up, and my king fell off the little shield that he was standing on, so he lost his balance, and I gotta help him get back on to that thing. The good news is I've made a lot of progress over the last couple of years on painting all my little minis. Oh, thanks, Dave. I appreciate it. I thought I'd missed you for a while, but I wasn't sure. Like I said, I'm always working when you're on with live stream, so I don't get to watch as long as I would like. I thought you were standing up when you painted, and then I realized that you were actually on a stool. I was in shock. I can't believe you. I don't know how you can paint while standing. Oh yeah, I love the king set. And like I said, I got him in storage. He's all painted, and I'll probably do the same thing with him that I'm doing with these guys. I don't really plan on repainting them. I kind of want to save the old, you know, my childhood stuff. I just want to give them a proper base. Especially that king set. You know, back then I didn't have a 2x1 plastic base to put them on, and I didn't even think about making a 2x1 cardboard like I usually did. So he just kind of flops over every time I stood him up. But now that I've got some good authentic bases to mount them onto, he should be alright once I mount them on there. Yeah. And You know, I don't know. Is Grenadier still around at all, guys? Or are these minis lost to history? Well, you know, I don't know, David. A lot of people. It really depends on the people. I just happen to get into streaming and been playing around with that for a couple months. I'm not the greatest at it, of course. But I'm not too keen on my face being all over the place. So it really depends. I think the other guys that stream that I've seen on Twitch and stuff, they're really popular. And yeah, they kind of have the camera on the mini, but they've also got another screen with their face on it. They interact a lot with the painters or with the community. And you do the same when you live stream, and I think it's cool. So oh, I'm gonna have to look Merlotin. I'm gonna have to look them up and see what they've got. My best friend as a child had got from them the elephant, the war elephant. And I have a 8x10 picture. His dad owned a camera. What do you call it? A film processing lab. And I have the 8x10 glossy photo of that model somewhere in my files. I've probably posted it here in the past. But I think it'd be nice if I got a hold of one of those. I don't know, there's a lot of stuff I want to do. I started out just wanting to paint my old minis, and I'm doing that, actually. And of course, other things have gotten in ahead of my old minis in the queue, in this process, in this quest that I've undertaken of painting all my old minis. But then I look on Ironwind Metals and I see all these old minis that I remember. And I just want to get all of those and paint them. And then there's other vendor, and I think he's in the UK as well. He's got, what's his name again? Antediluvian? I think it's Antediluvian Miniatures. They've got pig-faced orcs, which I love. Some of the guys I play D&D with now don't even know what a pig-faced orc is. They're all, you know, they're younger than I am. And I have to tell them that orcs originally had pig faces. Not these mutant faces that they have now. I would say the orcs depicted now would be more like what we would call a goblin back in our day, as opposed to being an orc. I just realized I'm curing myself, which makes it hard for me to talk. Let's see if I can fix that. There we go. So much lead, so little time. Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's for sure. Let me ask you, you guys, I know you're an avid miniature collector. Do you have any plastic in your collection? Or are you strictly metal? What a metal question to ask, right? Sometimes I move off camera trying to get a better view. It's a product of my nearsightedness. So this is going to take a little bit to dry because I've really watered it down just so it can get soaked into the baking powder. Maybe the first guy I painted might be dry. But this is the last one of the set, and I got 2, 4, 7 guys. That was quick. I'm not done, that's for sure, but get that base coat is good. What do you got, 4? Ooh, minifigs released old pig's face orcs. Otherworldly mint ones, yeah. Unnecessary evil these days, plastics. Yeah, I like, I have to say I love Ral Partha, and so when I found Ironwind Metals, of course that for me was it. And I've got a list of minis I want to get from them. I think two minis for me that jump out in my head that I want to get are kind of replenished, two that I lost during the course of the last 50 years. And that is, there was a dwarven warlord who's just standing there holding the hilt of his sword. And he's got two great horns, and I painted him when I was a kid, and I cannot tell you where he went. I don't know where he got lost. I don't understand it because I didn't take these guys out for years. They kind of just weren't living in a box. But he's gone. And then, of course, I had a gnome that came in the sorcerer's box from TSR. And I think it would be cool to get a hold of him again. Something tells me he might be hard to get a hold of, but TSR models were also Grenadier boxes, so maybe those Italian guys have some of those. Yeah, I knew you'd know which one. That, and I had it. It's funny how you find out these things become classics, and you just had it when you were a kid. I loved that mini. And, you know, he would be the dwarf in the group would be that one, you know. We didn't just have any old dwarf. We had that guy who may have been even a king, right? He would have been the oaken shield of my group when I was playing D&D. What else? Oh, and I think is it Otherworldly or Antediluvian? They've got the grown-up versions of the Dungeons and Dragons cartoon characters, and that is high on my list to acquire. Yeah, and the Venger, and the Dungeon Master, and that would be you get him to paint him the way they look in the cartoon. You're not gonna deviate from that paint job. It's something you just want to, at least I just want to have in my collection. Yeah, I've seen the Citadel once, so I met a bunch of guys who play Warhammer, and they have Citadel dwarves and stuff from way back, the metal ones, and they are impressive. Bigger than the Ral Partha, of course, but still impressive. Very, very much, very expressionistic. Hey, look at me, I got paint in my furrow. That's not good. I'm gonna end up turning this brush into a dry brush if I keep that up. Let's put this guy over here. These guys look like they're all still wet. Might need to have a second pass at them just to get rid of the green. There's so many minis that I see now that I want. There's the Dragonlance. I don't know. Does anybody make the Dragonlance dragon with the rider? Or is that something you have to find, hunt for on eBay from back in the day? That's something else that I wouldn't mind getting a hold of. That'd be a project for me. Another one to add to the many. Oh, and another thing that I noticed, I was streaming earlier, like I said, on Twitch, and I showed the guys how this is a new Relparsa horse. I know they changed the metal they use, and this is the Relparsa horse I bought when I was a kid. And you can tell this is pewter. This, I think, you guys use some kind of aluminum now, right? You can tell the difference. This is only like a couple months old off of Ironwood Metals. And this is from, you know, when I was a kid. Put this guy back up here and let him dry. He's curing. Let's see. Oh, wrong window. I'll do it like that. I gotta get one of those mats that everybody has, right? The cutting board, cutting mats. Oh man, none of them have been reproduced. That's a shame. I'd probably hang that from the ceiling in my office just to have it flying around here. Let me get some of this cook out of the back of my pot. I'm gonna need some more of that paint someday. Not too thick, not too thin. This guy's not in bad shape though. Just get this over like this. Like this. Like this. Do you know, I know that you guys seem, I know you have a company that you do your own minis, which is awesome. I have pondered on the idea, given that I would sculpt them in a computer and then print them and then have molds made. I'm just not 100% clear on where to start with that, aside from getting the sculpts done, of course, that's the first step. But I wouldn't want to, I'd venture in with a buddy of mine to do it, but I wouldn't want to waste anybody's time until I had sourced the proper sources for it. And I think we have a few other fellas on the in old school minis that that do their old that mold their own or cast their own minis for sale, of course, which I always thought was incredibly awesome. If you see me pausing, it's because I'm looking at the chat window to make sure I don't miss any statements from anybody. Oh. This is obviously one of my go-to colors because it's almost out. But I think I have enough to do what I need to do for these guys. Come back over this with a dry brush. Maybe I put some wash to get some dark tones into the crevices. And then I come over the top with a light colored dry brush. Surely I don't want to leave any white powder unpainted. Lich. There we go. Yeah. Running out of paint. And everything's closed. What shall I do? Get in that notch. There we go. This little bit here, like that. Oh yeah. Well, I've seen the political minis, which are cool, and then I've seen your lizard folk, which are also awesome. I wouldn't mind having like an army of those guys. Again, I know those are other minis on my list to get. And then there's your Noggin the Noggin guy. So I'm not clear 100% where that's from, if that's something you made up yourself. Some kind of licensing you got, or is that a thing? I gotta read more. I know you've got it posted, and I saw you have a blog now, so I gotta get into that blog. Check out all your stuff, but I've been on the webpage, and it's awesome, by the way. But is that something you do, like, are you, like, molding these guys in the backyard, or are you sending them out to get done, or, and if I'm asking a personal question or something that's none of my business, by all means, just let me know. I'm just interested in that aspect of the hobby as well. But maybe if you did a Kickstarter where you pre-fund your next release, that would help you to not have to be, so that it wouldn't be such a money pit. That's just an idea. I mean, I've never done it. I thought it was a licensed property. Okay. Because they do look familiar. And I think they're pretty cool. Like, I'd use those noggins in my D&D game. No problem. They're pretty neat too. I just I'm gonna get some water real quick. That's not brown. Be right back. You can still talk while I'm getting water. I got my headset on. So you can hear me. Of course you guys want to hear me in the bathroom, right? No? That's not a thing. It's probably a thing, but not for this. Not for this page. Oh. I bet you it's on YouTube, and I'm going to go looking for it next. When I get out of here tonight. You know how it is. I watch, you know, when I started painting again a few years ago, I had no idea there was a bunch of other 40 and 50 year olds out there doing the same thing that I wanted to do already. And then I found this group, which was awesome and very helpful. And here I am. I think it's been now, I don't know, 5 years I've been painting. I mean, I painted when I was a kid, but when I started up again, the first mini I started painting, and I'm pretty sure I've said this a million times, is the Ultimate ATV from Ralpartha. I had that sucker in a box for all these years. Never, I mean, I took him out to look at him, but never built him because he was gifted to me right around when I had stopped hobbying. And you can hear my neighbors outside talking whatever they talk. Such is the nature of where I live. But anyhow, yeah. And I just picked up where I left off. I started painting with oil-based paints again. And I found solvent-based paints, which I don't even know if they existed when I was a kid, but that's what I got. But I really like the water-based. There was, I mean, I like them all. They all have their purpose. But the water-based seems to be the way to go for what we do. But like these guys, when I painted them way back when, I didn't prime that. That's oil-based paint right on metal, you know? There's a lot of us slightly older people. Yeah. Who knew? We couldn't find each other in Miami here. Not too many of us. But now there's the internets. So we can do it on the internet. So I should not have brought them all here. Should have got the Trias guy out first. Because I still see green. Let me see if I can remedy that. This guy's wet. Oh, wait. I have one more guy to do. That's what I got. We missed our drummer. Our drummer needs attention. This is the Nico Brain of the Skeletal Legion. Anybody know who Nico Brain is? Homeworld Enamels were my first paints. Did we have those in the US? I think, yeah, I've heard of those. I remember later seeing, of course, like I said, I had Tamiya. Tamiya was awesome. They had all the right colors that you would want. Because we did this and we did a lot of World War II model building. You know, building our Sherman tanks and our Panzer V's. And of course the British Pink Panther Jeep was awesome. That model was a cool model. It was a lot of crossover with painting our D&D minis and painting our plastic models. So, but those guys, the models didn't make it to 40 years, but the D&D minis did. So here we are. Then after, let me see. I remember I've seen people post pictures of poly paints, which I remember seeing a few of those at the hobby shop when I was a kid. I'm impressed that people are still using those 40-year-old paints. In there. I almost swallowed the drummer. That's what I get. What do I get for being so close to the mini? Get some of this dirt off them. Gotta preserve this prehistoric paint job. I remember painting these guys. This is this was a Tamiya paint. It was an ivory color. Tester's gold and black. This was also Tamiya. The drum skin and the green reptile foot here was Tester's green beret. That was like my favorite green paint to use back then. I need to let this guy dry. So Citadel just beat Poly out outright when they released. I think what year did Citadel start? I know I posted an interview with one of the guys that started Warhammer a little while back, but I don't remember what years he was talking about. And I think Warhammer was around when I was a kid. I remember there was an RPG. A couple of my friends played it, but we didn't do the wargaming. I didn't start looking at Warhammer until I started going to the hobby shop here by the house, which unfortunately has gone away. They couldn't survive this conditions here in the city. I don't think there's a lot of support for this hobby in this part of the city. I mean, a little further north from me, there's apparently a lot of support for miniature wargaming. So now, early as the 80s, so let's see, by that time I would have been, I'm trying to think of the timeline in my head, but that's about right for me. Citadel was late 70s. So I always tie them together. Are they not the same company? No? I'd have to look that up. What about you? You make these minis, which tells me you've probably been doing that for a while, or is that something you do like me? It's you just got back into it because you had more time now that we're slightly older. Excuse me a second. Oh, they were separate and then joined. Probably the wisest thing they did. Some of this here. Oh, this is where I screw this all up now. Maybe not. I wanted these guys to be in an arid terrain, kind of like what I did with my Moshar Mini. So I had a little bit of trouble remembering how I had achieved that with Moshar, so I had to go back in the box and pull out that Mini to see what I'd done then. So I don't mind getting this lighter color on his feet because it'll just look like dust, because he's obviously not going to keep clean. walking around in this sand. That's interesting. I need to add some lighter color here. Get away from the obvious problem is that the area around his feet will be darker than the rest of them, but I think I'll be all right. Yeah, I gotta, here's a good view. Politico started for the blog about 7 years ago. Marriage problems meant I spent more time with minis. Divorced 5 years back and went overboard with it. That is not specifically to middies, but not an uncommon thing to happen. I have an acquaintance who this thing's not autofocusing today. I thought this would be a better view. Oh, you know what? If I move this light, I think it tweaks it. No, maybe not. All right. Oh, I know how to do this. Hold on. Boom. So yeah, this is probably a better view right now. You can see the dry brush on the ground. An acquaintance of mine had a similar issue with a RPG that he wanted to start, and he started spending a lot of his time and resources into it, and obviously I don't know all the details, but I do know that it did not end well for him and the family. But balance, man. I can't say that I've had that problem. I've had other marriage problems, but they didn't really have to do with this that I'm aware of. This is actually a respite for me from my daily grind. This is my meditation that you are joining me with today. I'm glad you're here. I appreciate you hanging out with me during my meditation. It is a pleasure to have you here. And given from what I've heard in some of your other live videos that you've done, it sounds like you've been able to overcome some of the issues that you mentioned, so there is good in that. Get some. This guy's got dirt between his toes, which actually probably adds some good character to him. Yeah, he's sloshing around in the sand. Barefoot. Like that. See? There you go. When this guy was freshly painted, that gold with those red eyes, they used to pop out at you. I am not going to repaint them. I kind of like the way they've gone. This wear kind of adds a little character to these guys, and I'm going to aim to keep that way. Oh yeah, man. Thanks. You know, I work from home, and it's funny because you guys are like watching movie stars, because I'm always seeing you on a screen or, you know, in the void of the internet, and so the rest of my office works in New York. So whenever I go in person to the home office or to the main office out of there. Let's see, wait, this particular stone needs some interesting attention, I think. May get a wash after this. It's funny, I feel like I'm visiting the actors of a sitcom because I always see them through Skype. And then I get to see them in person and it's like meeting TV people. I don't think they understand that when I get there, I'm sure. And I'm not like starstruck or anything, it's just the nature of the condition. So when I get interactions with you or Mick on there, because you guys seem to be the main moderators of the group, it's nice. I appreciate it. It's like meeting a movie star. And then I feel like there's a few people in the group, and I don't know if you're one of them, like I said, that are like old. I know this is old school minis, but they're like, they've been in the business for a while. Crazy world of remote working. Yeah. Now see, this arid, sandy terrain is what I was shooting for. I might have done well with putting a wash underneath that, like, coat. I might try it with one of these other guys, but what did I do with Moshar? I put him away. See, this stone here has a bright white that needs to go away. Don't want to put a giant glob of paint on it like I have just done. Okay. So yeah. So how I'm curious, you know, so you've got speaking of crazy worlds, you know, without getting too deep into what's going on out in the world, how has this whole situation affected your minis sales? Did they go up because people have more time to paint? Or are they stopped because there's nobody available to ship them to the clients who want them? Or are you pretty much status quo? That's an interesting, I think that's interesting to know, you know. I might have to clean this brush in a minute. Speaking of, this is the brush that I call my crazy brush, because I like using it for dry brush. But also because it's all ratted out. But if I wonder if you recognize this brush. It is a brush that many of us hobby guys, especially when you were younger, probably have seen. Again, I'm trying to get in between his feet. Because that's the part that our lich, our resident lich, that's probably not a lich. Well, I hear the Kickstarter thing, like I said earlier, that's the way to go, because that pre-funds all your expenses, I believe. Most of the time. But like you said, it's kind of like a niche market. I don't know. I don't know what. I don't know how it works. But I'm fascinated by it. And I can tell you right now that I wish you could make a living out of it, 100%. Because I know you'd enjoy it. How well do you know the guys out in Ironwood Metals? They're an American company. I forgot what state they were in. But I was surprised that they existed at all. And then they have the Chaos Wars, which is brilliant, because now you have a reason to get the minis that they're trying to sell you. Right? And they have so many. Well, I did read that they shut the doors. So, yeah, I'm sorry to hear that it's slow. I don't. Yeah. It's rough. I think we're going to be coming out of it soon. That was a mistake. Shouldn't have wet that. One last guy left. Am I going to do that like this? Nope. That's not going to work. So I need to. Going to go like this. Standard bearer. If he wasn't holding that standard so close to his body, I would have added a flag to it. Or a banner. But he's holding on tight to that guy. Let me see if I can, yeah. Get this off of here. I can see some green. I don't want to see green. That just means I'm going to put a shrub there. Alright. None of the other guys yet. You know what would be neat to do? I'm sure it's been mentioned before, to do like a convention or something where all the old school miniature members get together and hang out. They do it a lot up there by Jacob. I met Jacob on Facebook. He's really helpful, really cool dude. I want to put a Chaos Army together. I'm not sure if it's going to be Elves or Orcs yet. Nobody plays down here, but I want to get it started. I need to find my black. And that's not it. Here, blacky, blacky, black. And we go, here we go. Heck, I wouldn't mind going to visit there. It looks like they've got a building from what I saw on the website. So if I was ever in that part of the town, I would definitely go visit them. As I would if I was ever in your neck of the woods, if you had a, you know, check out the hobby scene out there. I don't play a lot of war games. But I do like painting these little guys. Whoa, shoot. They did get me into Age of Sigmar at the local hobby shop. And I don't know, I wasn't. At first it didn't do it for me, but I don't know, I guess later, as I got into it some more, I started to appreciate the game. But I feel like those games, you're kind of tied to that army and what they tell you that that model can do. And I feel like I remember Battle System from when I was a kid, and it looks like Chaos Wars is the same way, where you can pretty much do whatever you want. You make your own army with your own fantastic creatures and heroes, and I think it makes for a fun time. I also like using these minis in the, oh, that was a mistake, some of the new skirmish games that have come out. There's a big Kami community around me, but I'm too introverted, unfortunately. Oh. Well, I mean, there's only one way to get around that. It's the first step. Just go one day. Especially if you already know what they play. I was the same way. The only advice I would tell you is to not go with any presuppositions as to how people play or what they play. And I'll give you an example. I started going to the game shop when I found myself with some time. Actually, I started going because I was looking for paint after I realized that testers was not the way to go. And seeing a few videos online, I realized that I needed to find some Citadel paints, and they had it there. But then they played Dungeons and Dragons, and I hadn't played in a long time, and I wanted to play, but we played second edition. Everybody there played fifth edition, and a lot of the guys, not all of them, guys and gals, which back in my day, there weren't too many gals playing. But that went too far. That's not good. I had to go in knowing that these kids, in some cases, are not going to play these games the way I was used to, that I thought. And of course the difference just in the way of thinking when they're that much younger than I did find later some old schoolers, but I got into 5e because that's what everybody was playing, and I learned it. And what happened then is that I had my way. I brought my method of game to their new game, and they had their method, and actually we had fun both enjoying each other's method of play. So that's my main advice to you, is when you get out there, if you do decide to go after all this nonsense is over, just go with an open mind. So it's just a game anyway. I know I painted another one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, maybe I'm crazy. Didn't I do this guy? No, I didn't. I didn't dry brush that. How annoying. Okay, let's get back to the dry brush, put this here. Missed the guy. The drummer keeps getting left behind. because he doesn't fight. He's always in the back playing drums while these guys are out in front. Taking all the hits. No respect for our drummer. Our drummer Nico. I think that'll be enough. Need to get rid of some of the paint off this brush. I think I know why I avoided. I missed him because I probably didn't want to mess him up. Because there's so many details close to the base here that it's going to be hard not to get it on the mini. But I can appreciate being a little sloppy given that I'm not repainting the mini. Kind of gives me some freedom to be a little messy. Here's a piece I want to get off. Right there. Right there. I was a bass player for many years. Drummers always keep the rear. The rear and the beat, but the bass player can also keep the beat. So, but yeah. Is there a buddy here? Get some attention that he deserves. And we'll go back to the black here. And we'll start with our not a lich. There we go. That is very gooey. So I'm going to water it down. And wish me luck. Here we go. Especially when the terrain is flush with the edge of the plastic base, then it's all about my hand coordination and getting the line right more than anything. And I'll never get it the way I want it, so I will be here upset the whole time that I'm doing this. I could not tell you if my talking through it helps or hinders me. In this instance, I can tell you that I already boom. There we go. Oh, what time is it? Oh. I've got a happy hour, a virtual happy hour coming up in half an hour. I think I'm going to make it. Have you had any of those? Work with some great drummers? Any names that I might know? that's a terrible statement because I'm one of those guys that I used to listen to all the music when I was a kid and still today, and I would not know who I was listening. I know the groups, the names of the groups, but never the names of the guys in the band. I don't know if that means I'm a bad person, but you see what's happening to me here with this edge? I'm doing exactly what I said I didn't want to do. So it starts to creep up the side of the bass in an effort for me to make it equal. Like that. Okay, two down, five to go. Virtual happy hour. So, no doubt you've heard that everybody who's locked up in the house now has been getting on Zoom to hang out and meet with the friends that they haven't been able to see. And being that I have been working from home for the last 7 years, and I live with my 18-year-old son, I don't really have people to get hang out with. I mean, I have friends and stuff, but anyways, I joined the social group, and since nobody can get together now, everybody has their own alcohol and gets together on a Zoom meeting and hangs out and talks. As a matter of fact, through the wonders of technology, that opens up that happy hour to anybody in the whole world, as long as you had the ID for the Zoom meeting and the password. So yeah, it's everybody, you see everybody on camera, and everybody's, it's BYOB, bring your own booze. In my case, it's usually water, because I kind of quit drinking after I had a health scare a short while ago. And we all get on there and talk nonsense. Usually it's just ends up being a bunch of people talking over each other. Most of the guys are quiet and the ladies talk the most, which is funny to me. And that's our virtual happy hour. I can tell that I've watered this black down too much. I'll let this dry. Oh, I just thought of something. So, I don't know if you've heard any news. This is hobby related. Testers Paints went bankrupt. When I went to buy the last can of Dull Coat that they had in the store before all this, the guy told me, he says they're done. They're not coming back. I don't know if you heard anything about it, but you know, they still make a great Dull Coat, or they did. What are you guys using now to seal up your minis when you're done painting? Or do you seal them up at all? Right, yeah, so with our workmates. Hey, you're welcome to come if you want. I think it starts at 6:30. It's 6 o'clock over here now, which means it's 12 o'clock there, so it's kind of late for you. It is 6 hours, I believe, right? Oh, man. Wait a minute, it's not 6 hours. Maybe it's 5 hours for you, because my buddy out of Poland is 6 hours ahead of me. So Poland is further east, so maybe you're 4 to 6 hours ahead of me? Oh, you have some left. Good for you, I only have one can. But I also heard that you can't leave it lying around for too long in the can, it'll go bad, so it's a perishable item apparently. But I'll run out. I'll use it up before it goes bad for me. I did find Tamiya. Oh, look, I screwed it up. I did find Tamiya sealer. It worked all right. I didn't mind it, because testers was so hard to find anyways. But when I saw that one can, I bought it up. I snatched it up quick. It might have even been the last can of paint in Miami, Florida. Doing it again here, where I keep working my way up the side of the base. Next thing I know, I'll be painting black next to his feet. But this is way better base than what they had to begin with. My skeletal army. Go. Two more to go. Matte coat by Windsor and Newton. Oh, you know what? I think I saw some people mention that on the group. And I gotta look that up. I don't know if it's at the hobby store or not. But I know that when I start running out of paints, since the game shop closed down, now I'm going to be buying my paints probably online, because the hobby stores here, which would be Michael's and Hobby Lobby, do not carry these Citadel paints, or even Vallejo. They carry these guys, which, you know, actually work fine for me. The pigments... The pigment in the paint is bigger. I don't know what you call the particulates of color in the paint solution of the hobby paints is bigger. A good comparison would be to say that the resolution on that paint is a lot less than the resolution on a Vallejo or Citadel paint. So you gotta water them down, but you have to be careful. You probably already know this, because they won't hold the color as well as Citadel does once you've watered it down. You know, this makes me happy. This is why I hobby, because I get happy. You don't know how pleasing it is to see this guy who's been with me for so long. And he's not even done yet, but he's been reviewed and on this nice base now like this. It just makes me happy. Now we have our crossbowman, for whom I had to customize the base because he did not fit in a 25 millimeter base, and I refused to put him on a 2-inch base. I've read that people put the gloss on first. I think I did it to, well, I know I did it to, I had a bloodthirster, I don't know what they call them, for a blood secretor for my Corn Army and Age of Sigmar, who I had painted to kind of be like the Mad Max guys from Fury Road, except with gold instead of silver. And my I must have clear coated them during a too humid of a day, and he got the frosting, which at the end of the day didn't look bad, but it wasn't what I had wanted to go for. So I found out that you can spray over your frosted matte varnish with a gloss varnish, and it gets rid of that frost. And so I did that. So that guy has, and then of course you go over the gloss varnish again with the matte to get your matte thing again. So what I learned there was what you're talking about now, where, and I've read it before, where people will seal their mini in gloss first and then go over it with the matte. What is the purpose of that? Is it that the matte gloss is a better sealer than the, I mean, the gloss varnish is a better sealer than the matte, and so you've sealed your mini, you've protected it, and so now when you use the matte, you're really only using it as a, for its matte properties and not so much as a protective coating? Let's see. I want to do that like that. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing here, but he's got a custom lip. And so I want to get that black and clean. And then I'll move him on the back side here. Do the same thing. I'm glad I left this guy for last. Saw what I did there? I had a wild hair coming out of my brush. That was gonna ruin my night. So I flipped the brush over. There we go. There we go. I don't know what that clear spot is, but I'm gonna paint it black. Like the Rolling Stones said, paint it black. And that, my friends, is the last skeletal warrior, the crossbowman, to get color on his base. I can't do that. I can't put pressure on this hand because I fell off my bike yesterday and killed myself. But I still made it to this video. I went head over the handlebars, stabbed myself in the gut with the handlebars, and pretty much lay on the floor and embarrassed mess for about 5 minutes before I could get up again. Gloss for protection, bad for the look, yeah. And so what I did was, I went out and got, yeah, let me see if I have it handy, yeah. Last can of matte coat in Miami, Florida, and then the gloss coat. So this is almost out. But yeah, so I'll be matting, I'm gonna be coating these skellies with these guys. Probably I'll wait till tomorrow when they're really dry. And then I'll add some shrubbery. I haven't decided if I'll add any scenery to the bases yet. My other Raul Parson minis have all kinds of scenery. They've got, you can see them in my, I have a photo album on my Facebook page of all the minis I've been painting since I started. It's open to the public, so feel free to check it out whenever you want. But my my Raul Partha skellies have all kinds of stuff, even a severed head on the bases. So this is a full day of me. Oh, see, this is what I did earlier during my other live stream. I reconstituted a lance out of green stuff and a needle. Not sure if I'm still thrilled with it yet, but that's what I did. The reason these guys are facing that way is because we'll do something like this before I go. Of course, the drummer's in the back, right? Let's see if that looks good from this angle. I think so. We could always move it a little bit. Right there. There you go. I will definitely post pictures. Oh yeah, that was, you don't even want to see the bruise. But yeah. So thanks for hanging out with me. I really appreciate it for you and a few of the other people who I know stopped by. They didn't say any comments, but I really appreciate it. And I hope you have a great weekend, Easter weekend as well, and stay well and stay safe. Let's see if I can figure out what I'm supposed to do. Here we go. Have a good night, guys.